I'm trying to fine-tune my programming to it, if that's possible. What the hell am I thinking? to where I can reach more of the boomer population. I got this special, supposedly, kind of a feature on my podcast gizmo I got here, and it's supposed to be, give me demographics. Well, as my luck would have it, I cannot get the damn thing to work, and they explain it that because a lot of people aren't listening through their kind of programming, I can't get any feedback, and I can't get any demographics, which I really feel it's an important part of what I'm trying to do. I want to see how many boomers I'm actually getting out to there, and because I don't get any feedback from anybody, which, you know, it's kind of bullshit, but what do I do? I can't control that. But anyway, so I just keep plugging along and stuff like that. But besides, you guys got to remember one thing. I always let my meds do my talking. Yep, the meds do the talking for me. Well, that's all I can say. That's right. And this segment, this particular show I'm putting out this morning it's called the Winner of the Live Studio Tour, which we had a contest here a couple weeks ago. I don't know if you kept track of it or not. Anyway, we had a contest where whoever won the contest, the grand prize winner gets a live tour of Captain Boomer's Morning Show podcast studio live, and actually get to sit down and BS with the old captain live, and I'll even give you some Java. Yeah, and you can come and play with my Axel bobblehead dollars. Yeah, and well, no, you don't want to mess with Carmine anyway. You betcha. And we got our sponsors. So I gotta say, Captain Boomer's Morning Podcast Show is a military appreciation station. Always have been, always will be. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Our prayers and our hopes and are out with you, military people, wherever you are. And a lot of people don't understand, but boy, I tell you, you guys sacrifice a lot. Okay, so I want to say thank you, young ladies and gentlemen who are out there protecting our rights that so many of us take for granted. But I sure as hell don't, and I hope there's other people that don't either. Thank you, military people. God bless you. When it's time for you to come home safe. Godspeed. Thank you. Okay, having said that, I was trying to get a hold of the wife whisperer. I heard there is really a wife whisperer out there, and I'm trying to get a hold of the wife whisperer, and I want to have him on my show so we can talk about what's up with our wives, what makes them tick, what makes them sick, what makes them click. You know what I'm saying? Anyways, we're going to have the wife, I'm trying to get the wife whisperer on, and I think it's beneficial for both genders to take a listen to what he might have to say. especially us guys. Okay, and after all, it is Valentine's Day tomorrow, so yeah. Treat her nice, guys, okay? You gotta treat her like a lady. La 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 la. What the hell's that song? Treat her like a lady. She'll give in to you. Oh, baby. Look at and see. You know what I mean. Anyway, get her some flowers. Don't get that cheap crap, guys. You know, those ones that are half wilted and the ones that are gonna be thrown out, you know, tomorrow. Late tomorrow. So don't get the cheap ones that are half wilted. Get her some good stuff. And as far as chocolates, I've always found out that a good old Snicker bar gets a job done just as well as that fancy Lady Godiva chocolate crap, you know, that you pay about $2 per little square, whatever it is, you know. Or that Garibaldi guy, whatever it is, San Francisco stuff. Wow, that stuff's expensive. Anyway, yeah. So anyway, yes, I want to give a shout out to Twin Cities. Got a listening supporter of the Captain Boomer's Morning Podcast. Lately, they've been doing real well. Thank you, guys. Thank you, my beloved Twin Cities. Rochester, Minnesota, Rock Island, Illinois. And Stillwater. Stillwater's always there. Always been there for me. Thank you, Stillwater. I love you guys. I love you guys. After all, you know, I don't know how many people know this, but supposedly, and I'm not saying it's right or wrong, I don't know for sure, but supposedly the Stillwater is the birthplace of Minnesota. And having said that, that's very special. That's very cool. You know, that's worth having, you know, and I'm sure most of us have in the state that has visited that lovely little town on the mighty St. Croix River, if I'm not mistaken. And if you haven't, get down there. It's a wonderful little town. Wonderful little town. Yes, it is. And we got to go to our sponsors now. We're going to be doing a little bit of Villages of Viagra. Yes, indeed, guys. It's that time again, the Villages of Viagra. You know what I'm saying? Where even a hard day is a good day. Thank you. And we got to get, maybe Susie Q is listening, my lovely cousin. She's in the Hospice, Wisconsin area, over there, don't you know? Yeah, and she is, I always give her a little wolf whistle, and a big old pucker up buttercup. Thank you. That's out to my cousin Susie, and my brother Bruce is down in Mankato. He's playing his guitar all the time down there at the Coffee Hag in Mankato down there. And he plays his guitar so much that he was once heard to say, "My fingers are bleeding." Yes, he did. Although a lot of people may think that was George Harrison in one of the Beatles songs, but it was my brother who first coined that phrase. Anyways. Well, I'm going to get a spot of Java here and stuff, and we can BS some more. If you guys are out there heading to work or whatever, and drive safely and all that other stuff. And, okay, I'm going to pute on. I hope you guys like a little bit of the Guess Who, because the Guess Who are one of my favorite ones, that's for sure. And, yep, well, here we go. We're going to play a little Guess Who. Guess Who, and I'm gonna be we'll be playing some more Guess Who in a bit, or maybe something else. I'm not certain just yet. But we're gonna be talking about this, that, and other things like that. And geez, there he is again, there's the help me guy. He's on all the time, and I don't get it. I mean, I can't help you. Who's gonna help me? Oh, okay, my meds, they help me, kind of. Speaking of which, I think I told you before, Captain Moon lets his meds do all the talking. And just remember, gang, this is a hobby. This is all it is. You can read into it what you want, or you don't read anything into it. It is what it is, and it always will be just what it is. Anyway, what do we got here? Oh, yeah, I forgot to tell you guys. Yeah, this is important news. This is important. Mars Magazine just voted. Yep. Mars Magazine just voted Captain Boomer's podcast a must listen to for boomers. Yes, it is. Okay. And they went on to write. I mean, it's right in front of me. It's black and white. Anyway, a must listen to the boomers, from the Rolling Stones to the Brittle Bones. That's it. Whether it's a trip down memory lane, or a trip from the 70s that you're still on, okay? That's right. Let's run that by that again. Or it's a trip down memory lane, or a trip from the 70s that you're still on. Thank you. I think you get the idea. Anyway, either way, the captain's got you covered, okay?